today we're diving into something I should have done a long time ago. The Tabular Model Definition Language, or TMDL for short. So think about this. If you've ever wished your data model was easier to manage, put in the version control, collaborate with, let's say I have a snippet of code that I want to share with people and they can quickly add to their model. Well, TMDL is about to be, guess what? Your new best friend. You're going to take it everywhere you go. Think of it as the missing link between your semantic model and a real developer workflow. In this video, I'm going to break it down and see how it fits into your Power BI toolbox. So you know what to do? Enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Okay, let's take a look at this report that I created. I want to make some changes. The first change I want to make is I want to get rid of dim underscore on all my tables. Now, how would you do that traditionally? You would double click on each table and make the change. You would go home and go into transform in the query editor and make the change. You could do that and that will work. However, with the new TMDL view, I have enhanced developer efficiency. It's a rich code editor that provides you with the ability to do formatting, write code, to do find and replace. There's keyboard shortcuts. There's IntelliSense built in. Let me show you. In the TMDL view, make sure your model, choose semantic model and drag it over. You can see the entire model here. This is everything about the model. And what I like to do, shout out to Rui Romano and Greg Brunner for pointing this out to me. Before I make any changes, I create a backup. And so the first thing I want to do is get rid of dim underscore and fact underscore. So I'm going to go here, create a new script, and I'm going to do control H. Control H is find and replace. And you can see I already did this. Dim is there. So I'm going to replace it all. And there we go. And then what I'm going to do is fact underscore. And then I'm going to replace all of those. And before I do anything, I'm going to get a quick preview and it'll show me all the changes. So if I click on these little items right here, that's red and green, this is what it was. This is what it's going to be. And so I'm going to close this and I'm going to go ahead and click apply. And it says, hey, after I click apply, some stuff needs to happen. So I'm going to go back to my report view, see some X's, but I don't care. I'm going to click refresh. And now it's going to refresh my data. Still broken. Let's go to see details. I broke something. Now I can spend some time debugging this and trying to figure it out, or I can revert back to my original model using my backup. So I'm going to go over here to TMDL and go to my backup and I'm going to choose apply and it's going to say, hey, you got to refresh. No problem. It's already doing better. I'm going to go ahead and refresh. And once I get everything refreshed, boom, my report is back to its original state and I don't have to lose any sleep over. So that really makes me excited. The next thing is this increase reusability. I have a calendar table in here and this calendar table has some properties. So if I go here, it's not marked as a date table, but if I go to month, I do have a sort by column set to month num. Now I can take this and share just this DAX, but that sort by month will not be there. But if I take the TMDL script, I can take pieces of it and do creates of a specific table, or I can take the entire script like I'm going to do now. I'm going to take the entire script and I'm going to head over to a new desktop and I'm going to go to my TMDL view and I'm going to paste this in and I'm going to click apply. Yep, I need to update it. I think it gives me about time intelligence. Sure. And then if I go here and I'm going to click refresh. The beautiful thing is if I go to my model view, you can see here's my tables. If I expand calendar and go to month and we go to sort by month, it's month number. You don't believe me? Watch. I'll drag this over, make this a table. There you go. January, February, March. And so if I wanted to share that date table with other people, not only would it bring the columns and the rows, but it would also bring the properties. To me, that's pretty remarkable. The third thing is that I have more control and transparency of my semantic model. But what if I wanted to create a perspective? Before, I had to use third-party tools like Tabular Editor to add certain things to my model. I can't do it in the desktop. Well, I couldn't before, but now I can with the TMDL view. So I'm going to go here and I'm going to add a new script and I'm going to call this my sales perspective. And I'm going to write a little code. Create. Remember, there's that IntelliSense. And I'm going to say perspective. I'm going to call this measure sales view because the only thing I'm going to keep here and then my perspective table is going to be fact sales. And then all I'm going to expose are measures. So my perspective measure, let's see, I got a couple of measures here. let's see, total sales. And then one more perspective measure will make it total items sold. Let's see if I get this right. So we click apply. Boom, it says add to the model. Let's go over here. Let me see perspectives. There's my perspective. Now you got to go into service to test out your perspective. But boom, I just added something that wasn't available in the desktop via the TMDL view right here in the model. But I have one more thing to show you. So I'm going to go over here to a model that I created. And what we're going to see, if we go to the model view, that both of these tables in direct query mode. And one of the things that we talk about a lot is once you go to import mode from direct query, you can never go back. So I'm going to click this table and I'm going to go to advanced and I'm going to switch this to import mode. It's even saying, hey, once you do this, please be careful. You can't switch back to direct query. It's import mode. It's gray, right? I'm going to go over to my TMDL view. I'm going to script my model. I'm going to search for mode. Control F, mode. There's import. And let's look for it again. Let's see if we see it again. Mode. There's direct query. I'm going to copy this. I'm going to go back up to import. I'm going to paste this in. Let's preview my change. There's my change. I'm going from import to direct query. I'm going to click apply. And then I'm gonna go back here. Look at that. Look, it's been back in direct query mode. Can you query the table, Patrick? Can you query the table? Let's see. Let's drop color on here. Does it work? Does it work? Does it work? Boom. All right, what do you think? Have you been working with the TMDL view already? You got questions, comments about it? You wanna see other videos on the TMDL view? I'd love to know. Post it in the comments below. If you wanna learn more about Fabric, Oh, Power BI, all the workloads in Fabric. It's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.